Hey everyone, in this video we're going to talk about the best settings that you can set up in OBS Studio. Let's get right into it. Now, the first thing that I want to mention is that settings will vary from person to person and stream to stream. I want to guide you through how to make the right choices for your stream. Now, before we get into this, I do want to mention that this is going to be a two-part series, and it may seem a little bit tedious at first, but I promise if you stick with this, you're going to save yourself a lot of headache in the future. So with OBS Studio, let's open it up and click the Settings button. The first thing we're going to look at is the General tab. Here we can choose our default language and let us pick a theme such as light or dark. I personally prefer the dark theme, but you can choose whatever you'd like. Next, the Show Confirmation dialog checkbox will give you a pop-up box when you decide to hit start or stop streaming. If you're concerned about accidentally going live or stopping your stream prematurely, then select this box. Let's hit apply and move on. The stream tab is where we're going to make a few important decisions. So first we're going to notice that the services selection is defaulted to Twitch. However, you can see a list of other platforms we can stream with OBS Studio. One of the most important options in this setting selection is selecting the proper Twitch server. So if you'd like, you can select the server that is geographically closest to you, but I recommend downloading a tool that will give us the best results. The Twitch bandwidth test tool is extremely useful. To let you know, I actually misunderstood how to use this in my previous videos. The best option is not always the closest server to you, which is why I started using this program myself. We will use it to determine our best server as well as what bitrate to use in a little bit. Now, the link for the download is in the description below, and if you're uncomfortable downloading any tools like this, I'll describe another way to determine bitrate later in this video. Once the tool is downloaded, you'll extract it with a program like WinRAR. I actually have mine in the desktop where I leave it and then I use it quite frequently. We can run the test tool and we'll see a couple of different options. One of the first things that we need to do is acquire our stream key. So click the Get Key link and it will open your Twitch dashboard. And if you're already logged in, you'll be able to do this very quickly. If not, just log in. If you're not using the test tool, you can get to the Twitch dashboard by going to twitch.tv/broadcast/dashboard after logging in. Make sure that you're on the Stream Key tab and click Show Key. You'll get a warning that tells you not to share this key with anyone. Read through it and then click I understand. After this, you'll see your key as well as a link that allows us to reset our key if we accidentally leak it to someone. Copy your key and go back to the test tool and paste it into the Stream Key box. Next, the test duration option will choose a time for your test. You can leave it to quick test, which will do about a 10 second test per server. But if you have the time, it's better to run it for longer as you stream for a longer period of time, and this will give you more accurate results. Finally, you want to select the region you're going to test. I'm going to check only the United States. Now just hit start and then we can determine the best server to connect to after the test is complete. Once the test is complete, we'll see some numbers by each server. We want to choose the server with the highest bandwidth with a quality above 80. The RTT time represents the latency to the server, but this isn't the most important factor. I should mention that this test caps at about 10,000 kilobits per second, which we'll discuss in just a bit. Make sure to leave this tool open, and based on my results, I'm going to go back into OBS Studio and choose the Dallas, Texas server. If you're not using the test tool, then it's typically best to choose the server closest to you, but again, this tool will give you the best results. I'm going to paste my stream key into OBS since I have it copied to my clipboard already. But if you don't have yours copied anymore, make sure to go back to twitch.tv/broadcast/dashboard and get your key from here. Hit apply and let's click to our next tab. The output settings are also very important. We're only going to cover the basics here, but OBS does include a good amount of advanced settings that are there for those that are interested. The first setting that we want to discuss is the video bitrate. This is an extremely important option to set and can be sometimes a bit confusing. Let's take a moment and explain what this setting does. Basically, it will tell OBS the rate at which we want to send video data and audio data to the Twitch servers. Now, the Twitch servers will then send this data to your viewers. This number will help us determine what resolution to stream at as well. With that said, as a new streamer, you never want to put this number higher than 3500. Also, as a new streamer, you should know that unless you have a high number of viewers or you're partnered with Twitch, your viewers will receive data at the rate you send. For this reason, I personally recommend staying at 2500 or below. This is so that viewers on mobile devices or with slower internet connections will be able to watch your stream without buffering issues. Now, if you're wondering, how do I choose my bitrate? Well, it's actually pretty easy. Go back to the Twitch bandwidth test tool and look at the bandwidth for the server that you selected. We want to take 80% of that number since we don't want OBS to hog up all of our upload bandwidth. But remember, no matter what, don't go over 3500. Let's pretend our best server showed 3000 at our bandwidth. Now 80% of that will be 2400 kilobits per second. So we'll enter 2400 into the bitrate box. For audio bitrate, leave it at the default setting. Let's hit apply to save the changes that we've made so far. Now if you didn't use the Twitch bandwidth test tool to estimate your upload speed, I recommend using testmy.net to run an upload test. This will give you a good idea of what your upload speed is. Your results might actually show up in megabits per second, so we need to convert them to kilobits per second. We can do so by just searching Google very easily and then use a calculator here. Now remember that we want to use 80% of that number as our bitrate, and not to exceed 3500 kilobits per second. Once you figure out your bitrate, you can then just hit apply to save all of your changes. So in part two of the OBS Studio settings, we'll be covering the remaining settings and we'll show how to set up recording, selecting audio devices, and much more. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like, and if you have any questions about it, please leave them in the comments below. If you really like the video, make sure to subscribe for more from Nerd or Die. We're gonna do a bunch more free resources, OBS tutorials, and a lot more about streaming in the near future. Thanks for watching.